Howdy ding dong doody guys, welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa 2 Goodbye Despair. With me, TapersCrazy. Well, last left off, we start the class trial over Nagito's murder. We're just like going through like what seems to be a set of traps that tried to set by Nagito. So let's continue on. The proof that the burnt rope on Nagito's right arm is a trap. Light of the duct tape. The knife in his right hand. His right sleeve.
I see.
It had no burn marks on it.
Take a close look at his right sleeve.
Did it? Oh, it's got no marks on it, really.
Even though the rope was burnt up, his sleeve wasn't burned at all.
Yeah, exactly.
A burn like this, no matter how you think about it, is unnatural. That rope was burned in advance so it would look like it was burned in the fire.
Yeah, it just seems a bit placed there, doesn't it?
Then Nagito's right arm wasn't tied up, right? He was able to move it freely, right?
Indeed.
That should be the case.
Hajime, that's awesome! I'll let you cop a feel if you want.
Eh?
Akane, you should not give it away for free. Make sure they pay you first.
Eh?
That's definitely wrong.
Fine. I just gotta get a Benjamin from him before I let him touch me, right?
What's going on? Someone died here! You idiots!
That's not what I meant. I'm talking about Nagito.
Oh, wait, what?
I mean, even if his right hand wasn't tied up, the knife was still stabbed into it, you know?
It's impossible to stab a knife into your right hand with your right hand. Ah, that much is obvious.
Ah, I see. How does that work out then?
Hajime, you tricked me! Give me back that Benjamin!
I never gave you a Benjamin! Well, you never gave me a Benjamin! Everyone has a Benjamin! Not only did she try to charge me, now she wants the money back? What the heck?
Hold on. There should be a way.
Then hurry up and spill it!
If it's something lame, I'll make you give back the Benjamin with 10,000% interest!
What even is a Benjamin? I assume this is something that's flying over my head. A way to stab yourself in the right hand using only your right hand. It's okay, there's definitely an answer for this. I'm trying to think how I would do it if I ever needed to stab myself.
Even if Nagito's right hand was free,
someone else did it?
How could he stab his right hand with his right hand?
If he threw the knife into the air and let the knife fall.
Oh, that's the
thing. Could he stab his hand that way? Is he a throwing knife expert? Maybe he propped the knife somehow?
Propped the knife.
And slammed his right hand down on it?
Oh, what?
Onto what? If he just propped the knife.
What would he have propped
he
the knife on?
He could have used his bound left hand.
If you're tied up, your arms won't bend that easily.
Yeah,
we don't know if his left hand could even reach his right hand.
If Nagito could only use his right hand to stab himself in the palm, then how did he do it?
Even if Nagito's right hand was free, how could he stab his right hand with his right hand?
If he threw the knife into...
Let me just check it. The blood's on the... Could he have stuck the handle of the knife in the Monokuma plushie and like held it up next to him as he was tying himself off, then slammed his hand on it? Maybe? That's just what I'm thinking.
And let the knife fall.
No.
Could he stab his hand that way?
For certain, if you get enough momentum, that's possible.
Maybe he propped the knife somehow.
Yes, that was correct. Okay. So he props it up using the Monokuma plushie.
He must have used that to prop the knife.
Makes sense. That's why there was a big hole in the plushie's stomach.
And why it's covered in blood as well.
He inserted the knife handle into that hole to prop it up. Then he slammed his hand onto it. If that's it, he had to place the plushie near him. And it also explains the mysterious blood on the plushie.
So the blood on the plushie came from Nagito after he stabbed the knife into his own right hand.
Oh, I'd never be able to do that, me. Like, my self-preservation instinct would just kick in. Ugh.
I see. So that's the trick.
But for a moment, I seriously thought Monokuma died or something.
I doubt that's ever gonna happen.
A bleeding plushie is super scary. It's got the same fear factor as a doll whose hair grows too long.
After stabbing his hand,
what?
He no longer needed the plushie, so he cast it off toward the fire's origin point.
Hoping it would be burned.
He probably thought the fire would incinerate it and destroy the evidence.
So what do you think now?
Bad luck.
I get what you're saying about the wound on his right hand, but there's still one huge problem. The spear.
Everything else.
Basically, you're saying Nagito committed suicide by impaling himself with a spear, right?
Yes.
If you think about the order, getting killed by the spear should have been the last thing to happen to Nagito. If that's true, how is that possible? He can't grab a spear with his right hand if a knife is stabbed into it and his left hand was all tied up.
Then he probably took the spear first, and as he endured the pain, he stabbed the knife into his right hand.
That kind of looks instantaneous.
There is a limit to his constitution. If you got penetrated by something so big and thick, you would die instantly.
Yeah. No, Kazuichi! No! Don't take us down that road!
Sorry, I didn't catch all that.
Like I said, if you got penetrated by something so big and thick, you would die instantly.
What is going on all of a sudden? What's all these innuendos flying around? It's like the Matrix here. I'm trying to dodge them.
Say it one more time. I need to record it. For reasons.
Hey, bastard, you better cut it out.
Yeah, for you, go tell him.
Like she said, in that condition, it's very difficult to stab yourself with a spear. It'd be hard to use a spear with a knife stab into your right hand while your left hand is tied up.
So you're saying it's impossible?
Aisusha's gonna say it's not probable.
But no matter what I think, I can't believe Nagito's death was caused by someone else.
I also agree with that. To think that one of us could kill someone with such cruelty, I could never believe that.
You say you can't believe it? You just don't want to believe it, right? But that's why you keep getting betrayed over and over again, right? Same goes for this time, too.
Stop stirring the pot, Monokuma.
You just shut your mouth. It's against the rules to interfere with everyone. If you even think about doing anything, I have a plan of my own.
What?
Mamonami's sassing me!
Out-sass!
It's just as Monokuma said. We've been betrayed over and over again so far, so...
Why do we have any reason to believe that this is any different?
This might also be the same. Calling this a suicide takes too much for granted, and it's too convenient.
Then are you saying there is a killer among us, Kazuichi?
Of course that doesn't include Miss Sonia and me.
Wow.
As Kazuichi said, it's true we've been constantly betrayed. But even if I'm betrayed again, I still want to believe in everyone. No matter how many times I may be betrayed, I still want to believe in everyone.
Jesus.
I also want to believe that there's no killer, but suicide is unimaginable.
Do you really think so?
But you said it too. It'd be impossible for him to stab himself with a spear in his condition.
Did she?
I did say difficult, but I never said impossible.
Huh?
I feel that there's some way he could have stabbed himself with that spear.
What kind of way?
I don't know.
You don't know?
It's impossible to figure out by myself. So let's think about it together. That's how we made it this far up till now.
Was Chiaki stepping up to the plate all of a sudden?
Everyone working together.
She's right. We've made it through several ordeals up till now by doing that. Then, even now.
Alright, let's do this.
I'm gonna shoot you with my bullets! Didn't serve a knife. Blood on left hand. Let's just read what everyone says.
Let's work together and think this through.
Hey, hi, the Zulu warrior!
When the spear stabbed Nagito, his right hand was covered by the knife, right?
He was only able to move his left hand.
Uh-huh.
But his left hand was also tied up.
His left wrist.
Then that rules out his left hand. If that's the case, the only other way is...
He used his teeth?
Or maybe he used his front tail.
Stop with the front tail! What is going...
What are you saying?
Have to put the perverts on this case!
Watching this Sony is freaking awesome!
What? If Nagito committed suicide, he could just speed stab himself. Even if his arms and legs were tied up, there's no doubt he used some part of his body. The other thing he could have used is...
How did Nagito stab himself?
His tail. Good grief. His left hand. Details. Blood was splattered on the palm of Nagito's left hand. For some reason, the splatter cuts off in the middle of his palm. Also, back of his left hand has a natural blood stain only. Okay. It's as if he was holding something.
Let's work together.
So I think that's what it is. Would he have been holding the spear?
His right hand was covered by the knife.
But he won't be able to get a good angle from the ground.
But his left hand was also tied up. Then that rules out his left hand.
No, it doesn't. Wrong, idiot.
Hold on. It's still too early to dismiss the possibility that he used his left hand.
Why? I mean, his left hand was tied up, you know?
His left wrist was tied up.
But there was something off about his left hand. The blood stain on the palm of his hand. Don't you think it looked somewhat strange? He only had blood on the lower area of his palm. Beyond that point, the blood stain suddenly cuts off, right?
When the blood splattered, that's as far as it reached, right?
That settles the description of that blood stain, but it's not the only unnatural blood stain. Look, there's blood on the back of his hand, around the middle joints of his fingers.
Like you said, it looks like an unnatural blood stain, but what's wrong with that?
We might need to think and use our imaginations for a bit. If there's blood on his palm and the back of his hand, what was his left hand doing as the blood splattered?
What was Nagito's left hand doing with the blood splatters? Gripping. Hiding. Oh, hey, get back your hand. Where are you going? Gripping.
I see.
Yes.
When the blood splattered, he was probably gripping with his left hand. That's why there's such a strange-looking blood stain on his palm and the back of his hand.
Was he grabbing his front tail?
Enough with the front tail, man! Jesus!
Perish the thought! He was obviously grabbing the spear! Now that you mention it, compared to the rest of his body, the wounds on his left arm are pretty mild. He probably made his wounds mild on purpose, so he could keep his strength while he gripped the spear.
Huh.
But even if he held the spear with his tied up left hand, it'd be impossible for him to stab himself.
Yeah, that's what I'm not sure of. That's right. That's the problem.
Hey, Chiaki, what do you think? Hey, don't tell me you're getting sleepy.
At times like this, you should always strike from a good angle. Just like fixing an old TV.
Eh?
Oh, I got it. Maybe.
Really?
Yeah, like I thought. It's no mistake that Nagito was gripping the spear, I think. However, what's important is what section of the spear he was gripping.
Which section of the spear is he holding on to? The shaft? The blade? The cord?
I see!
Oh shit, yeah, it's got a cord on it, hasn't it?
Instead of the handle, Nagito must have been holding on to the cord. There was a metal weight at the tip of the cord, but there were bloodstains on that part too. Plus, the joint between the weight and the cord had a bloodstain shape like it was cut off by something.
Isn't the size of that cut-off section about the same size as a human fist?
Ah, you're right! So this is the part Nagito was gripping, huh?
Yeah.
And then the blood that was supposed to end up here ended up getting on Nagito's left hand.
Jesus, that's a grim image.
But why is it so important to know which part of the spear he was gripping?
You're not gonna say he gripped the tip of the cord, swung the spear around, and stabbed himself, right?
That is where the clue to solve this mystery resides. Right, Chiaki?
Now, I'm just thinking. There's one piece of evidence I remember, and there was blood on a steel girder above Nagito's body.
I am sorry. Of course this mystery will not be solved that easily.
Nagito is gripping the cord extending from the butt of a spear with his left hand. But from there, how would he stab himself in the stomach with a spear?
It seems we are stuck. Shall we have tea time?
Yes, tea! Tea and crumpets!
At a time like this, how about we stick to the plan to think one step at a time instead of expecting the answers all at once?
Eh? You need to work on your naming things, Chiaki.
That's a long plan name.
One step at a time? What does that mean? Let's focus on the spear first. Namely, where it was and how it was positioned just before it impaled Nagito.
How it was positioned?
Nagito was facing up, and the spear was stabbed through his stomach. So if it's just before that... That's it. Could it be... The state of the spear, and the fact that Nagito was holding the tip of a cord attachment. If I put those together and think about it, I should be able to figure it out. Where the spear was and what state it was in before it stabbed Nagito. Oh, I'm gonna do some SSX surfboarding! Yes, I love this! It's kind of fun, I guess. No, it's a lot of fun, actually. You know, it just sends me back to, like, old school days of, like... You know, the old demos you got on the PlayStation 2, where you had, Wipeout and SSX and stuff, it was just... And then I started thinking about the other demos that was on there, like... It was an old dirt racer, and I can't remember what it is. Where's the spear just before it impaled Nagito? Above Nagito. Let's go this way. I don't know, it just gets me reminiscing about, like, old school things. Because I remember I got a demo disc from a fun fair once. Because, like, someone was having... Oh, shit. Someone put demo discs out as, like, a prize for, like, a game. Like, one of those fun fair games. It was just really surreal. Like, if we're thinking about it now, it's like... You get demo discs for free in, like, PlayStation packages, you cheeky bastards. Beside this spear, what else was above Nagito? A ceiling girder. Sprinklers too, I guess. No, it couldn't have been sprinklers because his body would have been washed. But yeah, I don't know. It just dates back to a time. I also remember playing the Half-Life demo back in the day. I don't know if you ever played the Half-Life demo. Fun fact, I have never actually played Half-Life, like, for full game. I've never completed Half-Life. Just in case you were wondering, or Half-Life 2. I've only ever really played Gmod as far as Half-Life goes. Should probably play that on my channel, actually. I think it'd be fun. What item connects both the spear and the ceiling girder? The rope and negative. The spear's cord. Okay, let's go down here then. Yeah! Hang ten, bitches! There we go.
It's all coming together.
Yeah.
The spear impaled Nagito as he was laying face up. It must have been perpendicular to him just before that.
Perpendicular? In the middle of the air?
If Nagito did that all by himself, did he have some sort of ESP?
I can make things float in my mind.
That'd be awesome, but he probably used the ceiling girder directly above him.
Nagito probably slung the cord over the ceiling girder, and using that as a support, he hoisted the spear directly above him.
Yeah.
If Nagito let go of the cord, the spear would have fallen and impaled him while he was laying face up.
I noticed a slight red streak on the ceiling girder. It probably got smeared there during the setup.
The blood on the cord probably rubbed off on the ceiling girder as the spear was falling.
That makes sense.
Using this method, Nagito could have impaled himself with the spear.
Are you serious? He really committed suicide? Like that?
He probably chose that spear so he could commit suicide like that. If someone else did this, There's no reason they go to all this trouble just to kill someone with a spear.
I agree. When I was investigating this case, I kept thinking over and over how strange it was.
Something's not sitting right with me here. I don't know why. It just doesn't seem right.
Why did the killer use the knife and the spear so differently?
So you're saying he needed to use that spear to pull off his trick?
Then this is for real? He really committed suicide? Every single wound on his body, that was all him?
It is something Nagito would do.
Not just that, he did all that while he was gripping the spear? That spear should not have stabbed Nagito until the very end. Which means Nagito wounded himself while he was gripping that spear, right?
He's a crazy person.
Did he put the duct tape on his mouth too?
He probably covered his own mouth so we wouldn't hear him screaming in pain.
Did he need to go that far? That's beyond crazy. Why would he do that to himself?
He was probably trying to get us to make a mistake. By committing a suicide that looked like a murder, he was trying to steer us toward the wrong answer. His goal was to get us all executed.
That's why he stabbed himself over and over again?
Did he want us to die that bad?
That's messed up. That's seriously so messed up.
Yeah, that's our Nagito.
Jeez. And I was starting to feel a little sympathetic toward him. How stupid of me. I completely underestimated his capacity for malice. A mind-boggling malice that threatens us even after he's died. That's the form his malice took. I've forgotten all about it until now. If he was here now, he'd probably be sneering at me.
However, there is one thing I still do not understand. He said he would reveal the traitor, right? Whatever became of that?
He was probably planning to kill the traitor along with the rest of us.
No, he would have said kill the traitor, not reveal.
So why did he not just do that in the first place? If he had no qualms with killing everyone, he did not have to cause a bomb scare to reveal the traitor.
I bet the bomb scare was part of the strategy behind this trick. He made us split up and search for a bomb so none of us would have an alibi. He created a scenario where any of us could have killed him.
He tried to make us doubt each other, and tried to hide the truth behind his suicide.
Did he cause a bomb scare for that reason alone?
He's a fucking bastard who killed himself for his delusions of grandeur. It's not that unthinkable.
You are right, I suppose.
Yeah, it appears we've come to a conclusion. Bastard Nagito committed suicide. It was all done by him so we'd be executed.
That should be okay.
You're not satisfied yet?
No, I agree that Nagito killed himself, but I feel like there's something that doesn't make sense. It's probably just my imagination.
Why? I mean, I sort of understand what she's talking about. I don't think it's a mistake to assume that Nagito committed suicide, but why do I feel so uneasy about it? Is it because we don't know who the traitor is, or...
So what are you gonna do? Is it okay to proceed with the voting time?
What do you think, Akane?
Well, there's no doubt Nagito's death was a suicide. Oh well, I guess my gut is wrong sometimes.
You're right. It is not as though we can draw any other conclusion.
Then it's okay to end it here, huh? That means we're done with this last class trial and we can leave this island, right? It's okay to read such a happy ending, right?
Then it's okay? It's okay to say, you've decided on the killer? Understood. Then voting task.
No. Hold on a sec.
Wrecked! Get shut down, Pushy Bear!
Hold on. Why?
Sorry, just a little more. I want you guys to wait just a little more. I can't help but feel like... there's still something we overlooked.
Like who the traitor is?
But the issue here is who killed Nagito, right? Even if we identify the traitor, the conclusion won't change.
That's true, but...
the mystery isn't just about who the traitor is.
Huh?
No matter how you look at it, Nagito's death is a suicide. But I'm a little worried, you know? I'm worried about starting the voting time while there's still a mystery.
Hey, what do you mean it's not about who the traitor is? What kind of mystery is left?
One of Nagito's main reasons for doing anything during the last stage of this game is to uncover the traitor and just generally harass the traitor. So, if we leave the mystery of the traitor uncovered in this trial, then we could be overlooking anything else to do with Nagito. So, I'd say it is actually relevant, even if we think it's not going to change the final outcome or the final verdict. Still need to think about it, you know?
There's just one thing that doesn't make sense, and it relates to Nagito's death.
I'm just having a think here. Why did he need to set the fire? Was it just for the rope in his right hand?
Yes. It's something even Nagito couldn't influence. He couldn't even tamper with the evidence for it.
Something related to Nagito's death. And it's something that even he couldn't have messed with.
You're gonna keep going? Here, I thought we were finally finished.
Something related to Nagito's death. Piece of evidence that even he couldn't mess with. Survival knife, no. Blood on left hand, no. No, spear, no. No. MP3 player. One of the bombs. Monokumi oil and the bombs are fake. The diary that monitored me updated every day. Special poison. Huh. I'm not entirely certain here.
I see!
The Monokuma file? Eh?
Is it about the Monokuma file?
Yeah, that's it.
Let me double check the Monokuma file. Details. The victim is Nagito Kameda. The body was discovered inside the warehouse near the Monokuma file. Estimated time of death to be noon sharp. Not only is there a spear stabbed in his stomach, or more. Is that laceration left out? Is it the time of death? Like, how did he know it was noon and we was. No, because he'd have known because the room would have been set on fire when we came in. So it doesn't, I don't think it necessarily matters about it being noon. Huh.
Huh? There was something suspicious in the Monokuma file?
The victim is Nagito Kameda. The body was discovered inside the warehouse near the Monokuma plushie factory. The estimated time of death is believed to be noon sharp. Not only is there a spear stabbed in his stomach, there are multiple stab wounds on each side of his thighs. Furthermore, there is a laceration on his left arm and a knife impaled through his right hand. The suspicious part of the Monokuma file that Chiaki is worried about is... What is it? What's hidden in the Monokuma file? And we'll figure that one out in the next video, because I'm out of time for this one, so... Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for on YouTube. Hope you can follow if you're on with me. And I'll see you all in the next video.